Hello and welcome to Xiting Xpert. My name is Alessandro Banzer, and today I want to show you how you can must assign and remove transactions from multiple roles. Assigning and removing transactions from roles is a very time-consuming task, as there's no such functionality available in SAP standard. In today's Xpert Tip, I'm going to show you a solution that has been developed by Xiting that allows such changes. I will demonstrate how we can remove transactions from multiple roles, as well as assign a set of transactions to a set of roles. Let's jump right in. Okay, so here we are in Role Designer, which is one of the modules of the solution Xiting has developed. And I've already loaded my PFCG roles into the Role Designer. And we can look at the roles here from a menu perspective. So we see the transaction codes that are assigned to the role. So for example, here for the basis admin role, we have a GRC admin role and so on. And we can see what transaction codes are assigned. What I want to show you is how we can remove transactions in mass from multiple roles. So we can see here, for example, transaction AL11 is assigned to multiple roles and we want to remove that. Traditionally in PFCG, you have to go into every single role, go to the role menu, take the transaction out, and then generate the profile. Here in Role Designer, we can go to reporting view, where we can do a lot of things with the roles. And here, one of the reports, we can list all the roles with menu objects. If I double click here and run the report, we can see the role name and all the transaction codes that are assigned. If I scroll down here, we can see there's multiple roles, multiple transactions. And I want to now filter on AL11. So I'm filtering on the object name and say here, just filter me the object AL11. And now we can see transaction code AL11 is assigned to four roles. And I want to remove that. So I want to do it in one shot. I select them all and say here, remove objects. It will tell me or will ask me if I'm sure. Yes, I am, because that's my intention. I want to remove these transaction codes from these roles. It will tell me down here now that the objects have been removed successfully. So it did a change. We go back to another report where I can see the role status. And here we can now see that my four roles, they're out of sync when it comes to PFCG. So what does that mean? If you double click here, it will tell us that AL11 is not in my project role. So the role that I imported from PFCG and that I'm playing around with right now has not been synchronized back to PFCG. So that's why we have an out of sync situation right now. So AL11 still exists in PFCG, and now we wanna update that. So now we wanna rewrite the menu, the role menu into PFCG. For that, I'm going to select my roles. I will do all in one shot, select the roles, and hit here, generate roles in PFCG. It'll ask me a couple of questions. So for example, first it will tell me, hey, the role exists already. Do you want to override? Yes, I am. I'm doing a role change. I'm okay with that. Secondly, it will ask me if I want to change the role text, like the role description, which I could update in my project here as well. But since I didn't do any change, I say I'm okay. Just leave it as it is. I want to override. And then it will tell me that Role Designer now updated the role successfully in PFCG. What that means is if I refresh the view here, so I hit here refresh, it will now tell me that PFCG is in sync. So if I now would go out to PFCG, I can see that AL11 has been removed. At the same time, I wanna show you how we can must assign T-codes as well. So we removed AL11, but now we also wanna add a couple of transactions to the roles. So here I have an Excel file. In column A, we have the role name. In column B, we have the object type that we're going to add. Here TR stands for transaction. We could also add function modules, web services, and other objects that we can add to the role menu. And then here in column C, I'm just giving the transaction code in this example here. I save that to my desktop, go back to my Role Designer project, and then I'll load that file as an import file. So I go here through the menu and say upload data file. I'm going to manipulate the role menu because I want to change the role menu. So I select that here. I select the file I'm going to load. I have it saved here, just on my desktop, basically. And then we can see it now tells me objects have been added to the role. That's what I loaded, now been added. We confirm that. Once again, we refresh the screen, my role overview screen here. And now I can see my PFCG column is again out of sync. It says role exists, differences in the role menu. So what does that mean? If I double click again, we can now see that the transactions that are added to the upload file do not exist in PFCG. Same as before, we want to push those changes now to PFCG. So we select the roles again and hit generate to PFCG button. Will ask me again, do you want to override the role? Yes, I am. I'm just changing the role menu. No, I don't want to replace the PFCG text. Let's just leave them as they are. And then again, it confirms that the roles has been changed. If I refresh the screen once again here, we can now see the PFCG menu is in sync. This column here shows me that the profiles need to be compared. So we have to run redo merge new to get the new authorizations into the role and the old ones out. So that's the redo, you know, the expert mode you can use in PFCG. That's still something we have to do in PFCG directly. But what we can do now, and this last thing I want to show you here, is if I go into one of the roles, like for example, the GRC admin role, and I double click here, it brings me directly out to PFCG. And then when we go to the role menu, we can now see that the transactions that are added through the to the upload file are now here. What's also, and that's why I wanted to show you that, it now follows the component structure, because that's how we set up our role designer module, that whenever we build a role into PFCG, it follows the component structure of the SAP system. So basically all the role menus will always look the same. So when a user logs onto to SAP and the user menu loads, it will load it based on the role menu. And since all the roles follow the same role menu, the user will have a very unified user menu, and it will be the same for every user that logs onto the system if you follow that process. That was today's expert tip, how we can must update the role menu. If you want to learn more about the solution shown in this video, please go to our homepage and don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date. See you next time.